I've seen the Joshua tree. Got down on my knees through the Virgin Mother of prayer. I walk last barefoot, strong across the devil's hot coal. I tried everything, I swear. But hey, hey, what can I say? I'm a desperate man. I said, hey.
Job to get the day people's money. Well, between the devil and a deep blue sea, between the devil and a deep blue sea, between the devil and the deep blue sea, that's where I am. I don't know what that means. Maybe means I'm funky and cool. Maybe means I'm funky and cool. Maybe means I'm fucking cool. Maybe means I'm in Nashville, Tennessee. At the Chiefs. Now, if it's in the groove, everybody loves it. If it's in the groove, everybody loves it. If it's in the groove, everybody loves it. The great Howlin' Wolf said that. Now we've a short time to be here. We've a short time to be here. We've a short time to be here. So get out of your rut and let's get in the groove. Get out of them ruts, let's get in the groove. If you're in a rut, let's get out of it. Let's get in the groove. Well, are you ready for this?
Yeah.
We'll see, won't we?
Yeah.
looks like a tempest storm. She can dance like a little Egypt. She works down the steak bar, steak bar. It just sounds fancy, steak bar. It pretty much is steak bar. It's a reptile house, steak bar. Snyder right there, just laying down a groove you can hammer nails with over there on that bass over there from Nashville, Tennessee. That's Tobin Dale on the bass over there. And on the guitar, that's my son Lucas over on the guitar. And man, what a nice crowd. This is obviously the first time that a number of you have appeared before me. So I would imagine if it is, you're a little nervous. First two songs, probably wondering what the refund policy is. The other is, I just write these songs and I talk about them. I wrote this next song here with a young guy named Hayes Carl.
Thank you.
She likes to be naked and gazed upon. Thank you guys very much. Hayes Carlin made that song up. Can I hold that for a second? And Hayes, he put it out on an album, came out, I guess, about 10, 12 years ago now. Came out of this album, and it actually won a bunch of awards and everything. And I put it out on an album, came out about 10 years ago. Came out on this album. The title of the album was A Enlightenment, B Endarkenment, hint, there is no C. It's the worst title there's ever been for an album. A lot of music journalists let me know that. And it's got this really creepy picture on the front. On the front of the album cover, I got my head cut off. I'm holding my own head in my own hand. I mean, I got on a pretty nice leather jacket. But you show it to little kids, and it kind of skips them out. So it's got this horrible title and a creepy picture. So you've got to be asking, Ray, why would you do that? Wouldn't be asking it to you, son. But next mother's going to be a train wreck. Well, I'll tell you why, since some of you want to know randomly. I finally figured out you get more attention by burning down the barn than you do carrying out the trash. If this should be the first time that you've ever seen me perform, you probably come to the conclusion that I am an acquired taste. And I am not for everyone, and this next song here should weed you out.
They put the clothes back on.
So I'm at my blues. I'm nice, I said that I kept playing. She said, have you ever heard this song called Polk, Sally, Danny? I just kept playing. She said, every time I hear that song, my insides feel like warm water. I just won't take off my clothes and dance around in my underwear. I sit her down in Louisiana, where our little girl so mean. Sean, Sean, thank you, Tony Joe, thank you. That's all I knew of it. But it was enough, she was a woman of workout. So me and this dancer, we hit it off. We hit it off like a metaphor. Like a metaphor. Rich uranium, supercritical mass, who he was, a chain reaction. It was love and lust, mostly lust, but it is a mutual attraction. So there I was, boys, at 21 years old. I had it all, I had a fine stripper girlfriend. Yeah, that ain't all. I come home 4 or 5 times, and she had called my Les Paul. We broke up, and she went to Hollywood. She married her an actor. She got a job dancing on the Hudson Brothers TV show, and Molly lifted from Max Factor. I'm glad she done all right. I got over her eventually, right in my head. Through the gates into the big, big time as a rock and roll star for 40 years. I just carried around an old gold-top guitar. But love and fate are mysterious things in this funky old world. It was 35 years ago I ended up marrying that mother blues tour girl. She has a boy. That's him over there playing guitar. He's a young man, he's got his own life in front of him. I don't know if he's gonna hang his life on a guitar. It's a hard old road. I'm really grateful that Kyle Snyder came all the way from Austin, Texas. It just sounds like a 3 Converse tennis shoes in a dryer. I say, man, I'm an old cat. I've been doing this for a long time, but I'm very, very grateful that I'm still writing these old songs, and I'm very grateful I'm able to still prowl around and play them for people, and I'm extremely grateful that people will come out and hear me play these old songs that I wrote. And you know, the days I keep my gratitude higher than my expectations, I have really good days. I was not expecting all you people to be here, so it's been a damn fine day. before they played there. And my wife, Judy, was the door girl there when she was 16. I didn't know her back then. She went away from home, got kicked out. I can't remember which. And I didn't know her back then. We met about 15, 20 years later and everything. And the girl in the song actually went to Los Angeles, married an actor, and got a job dancing on the Hudson Brothers TV show, which was the summer replacement show on CBS for the Sonny and Cher show. It lasted one season, Mark Hudson and those cats, and she got a job dancing on that. And we stayed in touch after all this time, after almost 50 years. We've stayed every 2 years. She sends me a picture of her and her new Lexus. I'm just saying she made the right decision. Speaking of my wife, Judy, we wrote this next song together, only one we've ever written together. And I had this gig, and it's a rough gig, man. I mean, the audience was really just outrageously, kind of in the sound. The sound here is just incredible. See that guy right there? Yeah, he knows what he's doing. And he's really phenomenal. And the promoter was really sketchy, but I mean, John here, the people here at Chiefs, I mean, I don't know if you know this or not, but I have a gift. I have a gift from the universe that during that first song, Rabbit, where I come in, I'm singing about the dog chasing the rabbit, and no matter how dark it is, as I'm playing and singing that song, somewhere over here in my head, I have the ability to count the number of people in the audience and multiply that by the cover charge and take 80%. So, we're not going to be doing any blues tonight, boys. I got back to this gig, I got back about 3 in the morning. I walked in, my wife, Judy, said, "Well, how was the gig?" And I said, "Oh, man, it was a rough gig." And is that too much? So I said, "Oh man, it's a rough gig." And I think I entertain ourselves sometimes. I said, "Man, it's a rough gig." She said, "Well, everybody turns a bad trick every now and then."
Get you 5 to 10, and everybody turns a bad trick now and then.
It's better to be content than have to always be right. You can't fix a broken heart with a bobby pin. And everybody turns a bad trick now and then. You got to have some scars if you want to play a poet. To get weeds out of a garden, you got to hoe it. Possession with intent, oh, still get you out of taking. Anybody who wasn't here, but this is a very special thing we have, you know, for a former audit. We have a trust, you know, we're building a trust, and we have a covenant. That's what we got, you know, like priest confessional. You people wouldn't understand that. Lawyer client. Okay. So, when I found out Ringo Starr was going to play drums on this track about 5-6 years ago now, all of a sudden, I got this text from Ringo. He said, be out in L.A. next Tuesday at 2 o'clock, and I'll play drums on crack. So I flew out there. So on the way out there, I'd already written a song with Judy, but on the way out there, I left those two measures of rest, you know, where there's no, just diamonds, where there's no instrumentation, you know, just a 2, 3, 4, you know, just to see if he would do the fill from Get Back. And you're going to have to buy the album co-starring to find out. And I'm not going to tell you. Okay, he did. It's really a cool thing. He lives in Beverly Hills, but it's not a big mansion. It's just a one-story, really cool kind of ranch house thing. But you go out there, and he has a studio at his house, and it was just Ringo Starr and Bruce Sugar, his engineer, and me, just the three of us. So, and he's really nice and gracious, like, would you like some tea? And I go, but, you know, and no matter what's happening, somewhere over your head, you're going, it's a Beatle, man. And so, but he was so nice, and so we finished the track. And we did it twice, because the first time was perfect, and then I said, man, and I'll see you play it again. And he did. But anyhow, so after we finished the track, he said, who are you going to get to play bass? And I said, I don't know. He said, how about Don Buzz? And I said, well, I don't know Don Buzz. He said, I'll ask him. He said, who are you going to get to play guitar? And I said, well, I don't know. And he said, I'll ask my brother-in-law, Joe Walsh. And so, at that point, I called up Chris Robinson, and I said, look, I've got a beetle and an eagle. I need a crow. And, he was a little loaded, so he said, yeah. And, but I'm very, very grateful for Ringo for putting that together and all that stuff. And the album I did before that was called Tell the Devil I'm Getting There as Fast as I Can, which is meant to be taken metaphorically. You know, imagine I'm an old cat. You get to be my age. You start thinking about your mortality. And like I said, it's not really a concept album, but there's a theme that runs through a couple of songs there, and that theme is I hope God grades on a curve. I'm not Mother Teresa, but hey man, I'm not Attila the Hun. So maybe a C minus or a D plus, if you want to look at my life. Maybe it won't get me into heaven proper, but maybe it'll get me in some sort of celestial vocational night school. It worked in the 10th grade. So, this is a little rock and roll fable. Troublesome back and a ringing in the ears. soul is as misspent as my years. I got a Princeton Reverb. It's in an old Apple case. It's in the back of a Ford Econoline. And it's a 6-hour drive to Austin and the Continental Club. I got a change of strings on my DJ-45. Tell the devil let them get there as fast as they can. Playing this old guitar in this alt country band. I'm guys very much. There's a video of Tell the Devil that I'm getting there as fast as I can, and that I did myself. And on the track, I had the very good fortune to have Lucinda Williams and Eric Church sing on that song on the album. And man, I didn't have to use guilt or shame. They just said, yeah. And there's a video that I did myself with just a bunch of stuff in iMovie, and Eric Church and Lucinda are in the video. If you should see Eric or Lucinda, don't tell them they're in the video. I didn't, you know. So I'm very, very grateful. Is Aaron Lee here yet?
Yeah.
Aaron Lee, where are you? My friend Aaron Lee Jasmine, come on up here and we'll go. Get you to play. There he is right there, Aaron Lee. Yeah. 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 Let's put you over there, and we'll get you a chair and everything, and you can play Tobin's guitar. Tobin will play bass, and Lucas...
I'll do hand
puppets. Yeah, once you go, we'll take my powers. Yeah, and so then we'll do a little... Yes, no. Yeah, come on up. This right here is Peyton Dale, and she was on the cruise. We'll put her, let's put her there so she don't back on the home. Oh, there she is. Come on up. It's just turning into a free-for-all. I did the album co-starring and co-starring too on Big Machine, and a lot of people said, well, Ray, you did that one song, you know, Don't Get Any On You Go to Nashville, and you've done some other song, kind of, you know, not that, you know, talking about, you know, country record executives and stuff like that, you kind of this and everything. So, man, you were signed with Big Machine. Don't you think that's kind of hypocritical? And I go, no, man, it's ironic. I can't remember who played on the album. I think it was Ann Wilson, I think? I can't remember. It's either Ann Wilson or Winona, one of them. All right. Oh, you're going back that way, huh? You good?
Yep.
Bullet on the necklace. pocket. So let's sneak into Anton's Blues Club. And we're here, Charlie's Sexton Fun.
So
I come down from Oklahoma with a pistol and my boot. I paradise, a deck of cards, a Bible in my suit. I come here as the cause of tears, not just to cry in shame. Seven stud eternal blood, just a looking for a game. I dove across the state of Texas, they give me a little time. I told myself to double cut the cards and old scriptures in my mind. I learned to love the tumbling dice and to believe the word. Tombstones or rolling bones beats anything I've ever heard. Patience is a virtue that I don't possess. I can't deny that heaven lies beneath a cotton dress. How small a part of time we share till we hear the sound of wings. I am lost in the dust of the chase that my life brings. Thank you. discord going on in the United States right now. Right there. Peyton, thank you so much. Peyton Daly. Full drums. I mean, like I say, there's a lot of discord going on in the United States right now, and I don't want to get into it too much. But if we're going to send those guys over there to take care of some stuff, we need to take care of them when they come back. No matter what you are, if you're Republican, Democrat, Independent, Tory, Whig, whatever, hypnotist, Swami, whatever, dear, we just do that. All right. A little song I wrote with Cody Canada. Let's do that, all right?
I know it's true. Oh, please.
You did so well earlier in the set by singing along on that song called Snake Bar. For some reason at this point tonight, because of the sound in the room and all that, I would like everybody here to get down in this groove and sing Crazy Mama by J.J. Cale Whitley. Will you do that for me? Come on. If everybody and all you people up there, if y'all would get down in that groove and sing it with me, it would be, and I do not throw this word around lightly, if everybody would get in and sing J.J. Cale's Crazy Mama with me, it would be most.
She said, if you don't do it, we're going to be so disappointed in you. And I know how she felt. Because back in the 80s, I went to see Bob Dylan. And I really wanted to hear Bob Dylan do Masters of War. But he didn't do it. Or he did it and I didn't recognize it. Bob was a little funky in the 80s, but he got Charlie Sexton playing in his band, and that was a great band, too. Now, Charlie went over to Australia with somebody.
Elvis Costello.
Elvis Costello. So anyhow, for you people that have that void in your life, that only having me sing up against a wall, redneck mother can fill that hole within you. Well, it may not say a lot for either one of us. But let me explain something for the kids. A long time ago in a land far away called West Texas, if you was a young, long-haired, cosmic cowboy, hippie musician, it was very dangerous times. This was before Willie Nelson sang at the Armadillo World Headquarters in Austin, Texas, bringing the hippies and the rednecks together through the power of damn good country songs. This isn't one of those. It's born in Oklahoma, so is that. And his wife's name's Betty Lou, or Selma Liz. He's not responsible for what he's doing. Star and Pearl and Shiner Bomb beer. Those are beers made in Texas, so he likes to drink Texas beer. He traded in his GMC pickup truck. He got him a Ford. He gave it to his son, who put a little plastic statue of Robert Earl Keen on the dashboard. He's a saint, and it's up against the wall. Redneck mother, sing along, you have to. Mother who had raised the son so well. An Easter for drinking in a honky-tonk. For the mileage that I've got out of this song. O is for okay, that's about enough of this. T is for Texas, comma, Luke and Bob, Texas, where Cherry Jeff Walker recorded this so long ago. T is for Tennessee, too. H is for, here we are in Tennessee. E is for enough of this. And R is for
so well, so well, so well, Easter morning.
was the best that's ever been done. Okay, listen, not really. I got some merch over there. Josh, great kid over there, and he's going to be selling those stuff. And I was hoping to sell some tonight, but after that, why don't you take the money you're going to spend on one of my T-shirts, maybe buy yourself a pitch pipe and a metronome. That really was one of the best that's ever been done. Now Josh is over there and he'll take care of it. We got Ross and stuff with us and everything. And once again, Mr. Kyle Snyder right there and Toby Dale and Lucas Hubbard over there. Once again, and thanks for the sound. The sound is, I'll tell Eric to do a good job. And thank John for the gig and all that stuff. This is a song I wrote a way while back ago, and I had the very, very good fortune to have it recorded by this band called Cross Canadian Ragweed. Right? And I'm so grateful that they did, because with the royalty check, I was able to buy a fence.
Home.
got there laying the ties on a railroad track to put a man in water. But they would sing, and this is what they would sing sometimes. Now tell me who's that rag? It's gonna river little. Tell me who's that rag? It's gonna river little. Tell me who's that rag?
Yeah.
Joshua Tree. Fell down on my knees to the Virgin Mother of prayer. And I walked on glass barefooted and I brought the devil's backbone. I don't have a thing, I swear.
Come back again. I say, hey, hey, what can I
Appreciate Eric Church. We wanted to have the whole thing happen, and I really do appreciate it. Like I say, he also sang on Tell the Devil, and with Lee Sinon, that was really a 3-2. He's just been a stand-up guy. He called me up one time, and they were playing in Dallas. I want you to come up and sing a song. I went up there and met him, and I said, how did I end up on that song? And he said, well, they were writing it, and all of a sudden over on the turntable was Elvis Costello and Jeff Tweedy and me, and they said, well, let's write the damn truth. That's what's going on. So that's how I ended up in them. So anyhow, we drove up to do that, and went out there, and like I said, we got there and had this whole band there, and it was great. They had all that stuff, so they called me out. They said, we're ready to rehearse the song, and I said, well, can this band play the blues? And they said, yeah. And I said, can you play the blues in any key? And they go, yeah. I said, rehearsal's over. this next verse. No, it's really rude. It's a rude, crude verse. James Kirkie can get away with saying it, but now, I mean, if I was to sing it, I would just come across as a sleazy guy. Really, so I'm not going to sing it, and you can't make me. I'll get it started, then I'll stop, and I'll let you sing the real sleazy part, and that way I will come across as a very nice guy, and you will come across as people in Nashville who have no morals whatsoever. Yeah.